Okay, so unit testing. And this is something that's very important to our users because they need to have a good baseline for how things are supposed to behave, and they need to be able to rapidly check in changes as they're developing using App Connect Enterprise. So we provided a whole new framework for that. So we're going to touch on different areas of that framework. So maybe if we start in the toolkit experience, Sanjay, you can talk us through how you create unit testing.
So right from the beginning of version 12.01, we added capability of a toolkit so you could generate a unit test for a message flow node. So there's different ways you can launch the wizard to create it. So let's talk about edit mode, for example. So when you're in the normal edit mode in the toolkit, you can right click on any node and say, so let's create test case. I'll bring up a wizard and you can specify what input message you want to use, whether it's an XML message or a JSON message or a message assembly file and an output message as well. And you can and it will then generate a test case, which is in Java, and what will be added inside a new artifact called a test project, which is now in version 12. And then you can then use that test project to test your flows. Separately, in the flow exerciser, using the flow exerciser to put messages through your flow to check that your flow is working okay, you can now, once you're in the recorded blue line view, you can right click on the flow node and you can say create test case, and it's going to use the recorded input message and the recorded output message as part of your test case.
I think that's a very natural way of sort of inserting the concept of unit testing into the standard developer experience as you're using the toolkit. So I've seen a few folks using that for the first time and it seems to land quite well. So if we think about unit testing, you know, when you unwrap version 12 for the first time, it's Christmas morning, you've got this new present to play around with. I don't think there's going to be many folks out there who've perhaps got the time and the leisure to create huge volumes of unit tests from scratch. So it's also worth highlighting we've got a solution there as well, more in the runtime side.
Yeah, so what we found is that customers, you know, over the years have their existing test set of data. They have all these thousands of messages that they put through their flows every time they do an upgrade or a new version, and then they check the responses at the other end. And we thought, okay, right, let's try and help people reuse these. So you can actually put your flow into bulk record mode. And so then you can run through all these messages or your existing test data, or you could enable it on your production system. So you could just turn on this bulk record mode, run your normal production workload for a few days, and it records the data as it goes through every point in the flow. And so between every node, you get a message, recorded one of these test messages that Sanjay said, but it actually records it for you. And so you get all this reams of data. And then what you can then run is a command, an IBM int command, IBM int create test or something.
Generate test.
And that would actually take all this data and actually build your test cases. It will write you these JUnit test cases that reads in these message flow or starts up the flow, reads in these messages, puts them either side of each node to check the behavior of each node. And so builds you these test cases for you that you can then build on and write assertions for and things like that.
And once you've done that, if you want, you can actually import them into your toolkit. So mm-hmm. if you want to see those tests that's been generated in the UI, you can import them into your test project and then you can extend them further and further.
I think it's only when you see these things running at scale that you appreciate really how valuable they are. I mean, you're looking in that JUnit view in the top left of toolkit and you notice that a single unit test can be executed in literally thousandths of a second. It shows that you can, you know, as part of a standard checking process, it really is something to run on a regular basis.
And the fact that you can pick up an error very early on in your CI/CD pipeline means that you're going to save yourself so much time, you know, rather than finding something that's gone wrong in production.
Right. You know? And then that's an interesting thing you just brought out there in your CI/CD pipeline. And some customers might then go, okay, right, well, I've got my CI/CD pipeline, I want to run all these tests, but I don't want to have my production database that I've got to talk to during running these tests. And well, we've got an answer for that too. You know, you can actually create mocks. So you can say, I've got this big message flow, this one particular node or these two nodes or something do database interactions. You can say, okay, just insert a mock. Replace this node with a mock node that says, when I'm invoked, just return this data. And you can say, and so that you can kind of get rid of these database interactions or these MQ or SAP transactions and then still test the rest of the logic in your flow early on in your pipeline, and then perhaps later on, perhaps you've got a QA run which does have a database you can access. You can run these same tests again, but without doing the mocks and test it against the database data. So it's really, really, really powerful.
particularly when you think you could execute those same tests using a Git hook or some other automated method that can slot into your wider pipeline.
Yeah, and if you go and up on OT4i and you look at our ACE demo pipeline, what you'll actually see is we've actually got examples of doing exactly that. You've got these Git actions or hooks that actually then run these tests, having done a change, or even as you raise the PR, I mean, it runs it as a, you know, you can't merge your PR without this test running successfully.
I think before we kind of give the impression that we've got it all sewn up, it might also be worth saying that I think there's plenty more that we can still do in this space. We've had some enhancement requests come in that are more about driving some more sort of dynamic behavior of what the test should do as you're running through the unit test data. So I think there's all kinds of things we could do there. And also something maybe a bit more unit testy around eSQL perhaps to help as we go through.
Yeah, and obviously you can kind of do eSQL now in that you could stand up a compute node that perhaps just calls different functions, individual functions rather than whole modules, and then obviously test that individual node. Or you can, if you've got a whole eSQL node now, you can just test, you know, once you just run that single node, put a message in, read the message response. So you can do it now, but I think there, as Ben says, there is a requirement to be able to write e-units.
Yeah, absolutely.
I think also at the message flow level, we want to be able to generate tests at the flow level as well, which we can't currently do when you do it at the node level.
Yeah. So e-units, we heard it here first.